Regarding invasive fungal infections 2020 updates, and how can we go through this? If you stop me at any time, if I finish my time. Changing epidemiology. We have now cases of drug resistant candida, drug resistant aspergillus. What is our local epidemiology in Egypt? What in Saudi Arabia? What's our local epidemiology worldwide? And rising incidence of resistant candida, risk factors, especially in ICU patients, and now post influenza, a lot of reports about post influenza aspergillus infection. Regarding the clinical picture, diagnosis, management. Now we have new weapons for fighting candida and fungal infections like rizafungin, which is once weekly, echinocandin. It's available now and with the good testing for the regarding candida auris regarding this rizafungin. All of us know that the gram-positive infection and the gram-negative infection fluctuating, but nowadays a lot of cases of fungal growth from the candida growth in the blood, and the mortality of the candida growth sometimes more than 50%, more than 100% of the bacterial growth. The types today will discuss for the fungal infections, we'll discuss the candida, yeast, or molds. Yeast, this is some sort of just rounded fungi like this, forming pseudo hyphae, not regular hyphae. This pseudo hyphae is the forming this pattern of the candida. Regarding the other molds, this one making true hyphae, either septated hyphae with acute angles like this, branching, this is the aspergillus. The other one irregular with right angle branches, this is mucormycosis. We'll go through this finding. And this is rounded without any branching, without any pseudo hyphae, this is the Cryptococcus species. This is the very important slide for today for the rising incidence of the rising non-candida albicans. The blue one, this one, this candida albicans, is going down. This also goes with our data. The non-albicans candida, including cruzi, parapsilosis, tropicalis, glabrata, and others are rising now. Do we have our local data for this fungogram? Yes, I made this study. This is another study was published in the Clinical Infectious Diseases. This is the fluconazole. We'll see that albicans is totally sensitive to fluconazole. Glabrata and the cruzi, you remember these two names, especially in immune-compromised patients. Candida glabrata and Candida cruzi is sometimes very resistant. And especially this glabrata is all azoles. Even busaconazole, even isavuconazole, the new Cresemba, is also resistant to this Candida glabrata. I did this study on 400 isolates of Candida. I found this is on 2000, between 2010 and 2012, in 3 years. I found that the prevalent, most prevalent was Candida albicans. Non-albicans was less prevalent, like the tropicalis, like the cruzi and the stain, and then Dabiensis. When I go and follow this fungogram in 2007, I found that the albicans became less and the Candida glabrata became more. When I followed in 2018, I found only very small percentage albicans and the glabrata is rising. This is very alarming to have that rate of Candida albicans, Candida glabrata, sorry, and Candida cruzi is very resistant. What about the sensitivity pattern? Is it sensitive fungus or resistant fungus? This is, it goes, our data goes all over the world. The same, albicans is decreasing nowadays, and non-albicans candida is increasing all over the world. And this is the albicans. We'll go for the fungogram. What is the sensitivity pattern of this candida? We will found that the albicans is fully sensitive. This is the fluconazole, 100% sensitive. If I go to the cruzi, sensitivity only 20%, 80% resistance. If you find the name in the culture, cruzi, this is very resistant. Glabrata the same, 40% or 60%. Sensitive, that say 40% will be resistant for Candida glabrata. Paratropicalis is nice, paraxylose is almost the same. Dabiensis is still fully sensitive. And so now we start to have nightmare of Candida auris. It started in 2009 in Japan. It started this one from the ear discharge. And name is auris, Candida auris, in 2019. Till last month in the United States, more than 490 cases of Candida auris in the United States itself from 11 states. This is very important message. If you go from the lecture today, by this message, this is more than enough. Candida albicans can sometimes, by zoobiotic or automatic cultures, can be identified as Candida humuloni, Candida thamata, Candida saccharomyces cerevisiae. This saccharomyces cerevisiae, if I go just very simple to this slide, I found this, what? Saccharomyces cerevisiae. I have three cases. In 2017, there was no good alertness by the Candida auris. If I dig after and do the essential diagnostic modality, I diagnose Candida auris, but at that time, we are not aware about Candida auris. And so, it can be misleading by this Candida humuloni. Look for Candida auris. If you found thamata, the same. Saccharomyces cerevisiae, also the same. This is the problem and current situation this month in the United States. The Candida auris, 33% multi-drug resistant. Resistant to azole, resistant to polyene, amphotericin, and resistant sometimes to echinocandins. Echinocandins, this is the last result for treatment of Candida auris. And two cases pain resistant in 2019. In the United States, Candida not curable at all. In Saudi Arabia, we diagnosed four cases of Candida auris. I'll tell you the situation now in Egypt. Almost 32 countries all over the world reporting Candida auris. This article from Egypt here, published last month from the group in Alexandria University. One of the patients came from Saudi Arabia and admitted to ICU here. The patient deteriorated, transferred to Alexandria. This patient was diagnosed with Candida auris in Alexandria, and they published this Candida auris. This patient came from Saudi Arabia, basically. The Saudi Arabia reporting nowadays is still four cases of Candida auris from Jeddah, from the Olympics area I'm working now. In Riyadh, in Dammam, four cases from Candida auris, and this the samples from blood and pleural fluids identified as Candida humuloni at first. And then, when we did after, it is Candida auris. All the resistance to fluid as well, two resistant even to amphotericin. To amphotericin, and the only way was the echinocandins. This is another very serious outbreak in Oman nowadays. Oman in 2019 of almost 63 cases of Candida auris in Oman. Dr. Nashwa Qasabi from Mansoura, the one who published this one, is a huge one. This is the modalities that are available in the lab for vital tool, for X, micro scan. But what's very important to have true diagnosis, multi-proof, which is available for the Tabar, which is Azim, or Guru Factor, and Magad, or Guru Fiend, who was a multi-proof. If you have this three and D and culture, you can do DNA sequence if you have one there, which is available already. So please, infection control is very important. Hashifin can be the bacteria of Adam, sometimes in United States, bad resistant. So infection control is very, very important not to transfer this one. And you should look at new paradigm shift. The fungus as a bacteria. But they are resistant, but they are transferable to the heads, but they are outbreaks for such health, which is very serious. Enhanced hygiene, please, is very, very serious and very important. But then epidemiology, look at epidemiology, will all over the world. It's factors. ICU patient, ICU patient, what the American farmer will get diagnostic culture to my pastimes, I can get a score. I should be IM, mechanical ventilation, more than 2 days, more than 3 antibiotics, more than 4 days antibiotics, time in ICU, more than 4 days, major abdominal surgery, sometimes I stop. Can CBB, total parenteral nutrition, notobelic immunosuppression, concomitant infection diabetes. If you have polarization, sputum candida, you can neglect it. But if you have sputum and your candida, and ICU patient, or antibiotics, this is sometimes very serious. What about Aspergillus post-influenza in ICU? A lot of work since 1950 about Aspergillus associated with influenza infection. As emerging infection since the last decade. Non-specific biological science clear this study done in 2018 between Netherlands and Belgium. They published 83 cases of Aspergillus post-influenza in ICU patients with very high mortality. The problem is that immune competence sometimes 14% of these cases were immune competent, normally immune compromised. So for this, we should be raising awareness and orientation of cases of association between the Aspergillus and the influenza. This is another recent article published a few days ago, and it says Aspergillus also influenza. Very important article also.
Who will develop this invasive cellulitis? The hematology patient, acute leukemia, and lymphoma patients from chemotherapy, bone marrow transplant, almost 6% of cases. Solid organ transplant, but one of these is HIV patients. The solid organ transplant also is very serious cases. The biological friend mainly can be the liver and kidney transplant. About heart and lung, mainly aspergillus. This is important for the prophylaxis, very serious. And this is another article of the association between the invasive aspergillosis and biologic therapy, which is to avoid taking biologics. If you are not aware that this biologic can be associated with invasive aspergillosis, very serious. Almost 280 cases reported of association between invasive aspergillosis and biologics. What about the clinical picture? Clinical picture for the candidal infection, either candidemia or localized organ infection. Candidemia, it will be present by certain infections we see now. The hepatocellulitis sometimes focal lesions with big masses when you want to take a biopsy without candida. This infection and then fluctuating fever, high alkalinity, so this sometimes mild dissemination, mild recurrence, or even with big wound outside and see that. Or if you know this candida polar thrush, this is extensive esophageal. And this is one of the reasons for HIV. This is before and after acid fungal. This is the candida bronchi with huge bull eye lesions like this. The biopsy here, candida, and this is renal. No one single case of candida to be diagnosed without talking in the fungus. Fungus examination is very essential. This patient needs 6 weeks and fungal. No candida without looking at the fungus, because sometimes we extend the dose of antifungal to 6 weeks because you may get blindness if you didn't give an optimal antifungal. And we also not forget also the candida endocarditis. This is the spectrum of the candida. The spectrum of aspergillus, you know the aspergillus, so magatus, levus, microanthidus, and this very important construction site. Many times when there is a construction site in the area where I'm working, most construction will pick a sample and we found a lot of aspergillus. We will not talk in this place till complete eradication of aspergillus in the place. This is very, very serious. Construction areas. In the ICU, this is very serious and should scan for aspergillus post construction. The problem with aspergillus is everywhere around us. You see this one? All these areas containing aspergillus. The reaction of the body, how the aspergillus will present, will depend on the fight between the immune and the organism. If you have very poor immunity, patient with acute leukemia, or stem cell transplant, and the immunity is very low, you will have acute invasive aspergillus. If you have the extreme, immune hyperactivity, you have allergic broken-word aspergillosis. In the middle, you find aspergillosis in a category like the case we present now. What are the only signs of aspergillosis? Bulbarity, number one, multiple paralysal sinuses, and this is the aspergillosis in a category. This patient upright, this patient sleeping, and most operative, this is the sign of aspergillosis. When people have surgery and treatment, when to treat these cases? This is aspergillosis and sinus. Extensive aspergillus sinusitis, endocarditis, even aspergillus endophthalmitis, which needs some time to put a tiny fungal inside the body. This is the third part of my talk about the mucormycosis. Mucormycosis is the risk factor for mucormycosis, especially when I was a resident, so I might have to stress this right now. After the habit of getting a diabetic, mucormycosis will lay black iscus in the nose, and this is the bad diabetic, black area in the bad. This is a mucormycosis. If you didn't diagnose, this is nearly human disease. Hematologic malignancies, neutrophil patients, those, for this, hematologic malignancies, we are giving 2 samples for prevention of this one. Malnourished. This trial, what I am creating there, the brain that I want, will make you susceptible to the mucormycosis. This my oral one can be used in treatment. We'll see for the treatment how we can use the oral creating therapy for the treatment. This is, I saw this patient very fragile, this going from the back to the face. This is, when you go in the back, you found this one. You see, black is the back, very serious. Mucormycosis sometimes can present in the stomach. You see, I'm doing the bare body. When you do a gastrectomy, you found this one. Mucormycosis can even be having black discard in the hand. can be newborn mycosis. How do I use to prepare ourselves now for the treatment modalities? Give us 7 minutes. And diagnosis, when we go to diagnose the problem, what is the problem with the fungal infection? This is the fungal infection, what is our mind? It's not specific. Clinical signs, fever, rash, cough, dyspnea, big chest or abdominal pain, even septic shock, sometimes hemoxysis, vascular invasion, convulsions, and CNS disease. The radiological, we see the radiology now. What did we have? The radiology will progress, and the problem is here. You should have high index of suspicion of these fungal infections, especially now it's almost nearly fatal and even sometimes very resistant. As we see already. When the radiologist will find sometimes air crescent signs from air, here come this air crescent, will start first by this area of the hyper intensity inside, and then around this halo. What is this halo sign? This is vascular invasion by the fungus causing bleeding around the fungal infection. This is called halo sign. And so it starts by halo sign like this. After this halo sign, the size will increase and here will disappear and will end by this one. What is this one? The vascular migration of the fungus causes necrosis of the lung. The lung will retract like this, leaving this air around. This is called air crescent sign. Not only that, there's something called reverse halo sign. What is reverse halo? You will find enhanced peripheral and the central hypersensitive sensitive of the sign. Another case I saw with the reverse halo sign in the CT scan. What about big scan? Sometimes misleading. You are diagnosing big scan for the variants. Sometimes it can be for the fungal infections, still this prominent manifestation. The gold standard is blood culture, but we have already the multi proof, which can become sometimes very essential for definition and diagnosis. And the results from multi proof can be released in 30 minutes. 30 minutes from multi proof. Which is very early. The management, my colleagues and my colleagues can say about the multi-proof much better than me. This is the machine for the multi-proof. The serology is very important as well, even for the National Radio Hospital. We have the serology for gastrointestinal or 1-3-D leukemia. This is mainly for the candida and this is mainly for the aspergillus. It is like that sometimes you can accept the mucosis in aspergillus or candida at the same time. The problem is sometimes some of the antibiotics available will react with the acid and those positive acid in spite of the patient doesn't have fungal infections. BCR and filter array also is very important. Just a few words in the management. This is the fungal cell. This is the fungal cell membrane. This is the fungal cell wall outside and this is the nucleus inside. If you work, if you, the medicine work in the cell membrane, we have only antibiotics, amphotericin. And this is analytical and for the formulation of this. As well as we have pitiprazole, etraconazole, flu, voiprazole, oxaconazole, and isaconazole, prazole, and we see the difference between this one as well. And the second group, DNA synthesis, this is flu cytosine. It's not available on this issue, but available outside. Same one, this is the chemocantins. Chemocantins started in the year 2000, I started using this one in 2000 in the UK. Casprofungin, Micafungin, and Albuterafungin. And this is a new modality, which is Litafungin. It implanted once a week, very, very, even resistant, and always can be very responsive according to the literature we see now. Amphotericin is how it works, by the sphere forming groups, and this is fungicidal, It came from the broad spectrum, it acts on the amphotericin, the candida, on the aspergillus, and the core. It's broad spectrum, and this is the ambisome, and this is the three forms of the liquid formulation. I use the albicet, I use the ambisome, but this is the best medicine for the management, less, more effective, less toxicity, and the infusion toxicity is less, and the problem is the positive medicine. This is the ambisome, and this is the fungisome, the regular amphotericin. Regarding this, as well as I this enzyme, give a less enzyme, forming the formation, enabling the formation of atmosphere. All of them are fungus static, not fungus cellular. This is the azole that we have, ketalan, flu, and voic azole, and the mucosa azole, which can be used in the either aspergillus or mucor mycosis game. This is the flu azole, and voic azole is more broad spectrum, and this is not one indication for aspergillus is voic azole. The most important medicine for managing aspergillus is voic azole. And the problem is the visual problem for the visual disturbance of the cortisol and photosensitivity. If you didn't take them, your patient taking cortisol. Don't stay in the sun. Sometimes it's severe burden from the cortisol. If you are not aware of the medicine, don't use it, please. This pusatinazole is the only azole that acts against type 1 disease for mucormycosis. Pusatinazole. Isatinazole is a new medicine. Please, I have seen here in Egypt many times using folinazole IV in renal failure patients. This is a crime. It will get cyclic extreme. Cyclic extreme is neurotoxic. Sometimes they do coma and don't fall asleep. Please, you should not use the folinazole intravenous in renal failure patients. If you want to use it, you can use it orally with very high bioavailability for the folinazole. This is the isatinazole, this is the folinazole, this is the pusatinazole, rosafir, which is available now in the late tablets, available in Egypt already. The IDCARE methods work by extracting this enzyme, the glucansin 6 enzyme, extracting the fungal cell, and so this fungicide, as you see, is a very important fungicide. The only IDCARE method which works in Aspergillus is casmofungin. Others do not work in spine. This is not, they didn't take the FDA approval for using this medication, but it affected the aggregates and the grasses or gas, tozine, and then the oils can be treated by casmofungin. And this is the three medicine. And the difference between these three medicines is one, the anidulafungin will pass the hepatic and renal metabolism. It is slow, so it is human degradation and renal excretion. And others, casmofungin and mucofungin, it needs the liver and kidney, and this is for this system, being in bad patients, very serious. This is the casmo, and this is my domain, and this is the Galta, and this is just one thing more than risafungin. The new era for management of antifungal infections is once an evening, it can be effective even in categories like this article. You get the killing effect of risafungin and idulafungin and casmofungin against antifungal, it was the biggest problem for against Candida auris. So then the first guidelines, the guidelines include mainly the work that should have Candida, the children of acetyl-IN. When the patient is more than that, unstable, we start from the first, we can find it, especially when we have Candida, prophylaxis, then as well. Now, IN on top, mainly Aspergillus, not working in the patient is volume as well. But we said this therapy, and we said this therapy, I am back in volume as well. Of course, we have a bit of stuff, and back in the medicine, we have an amphotericin, and this is persisting, they stop the medicine, but then the whole stuff is just to see. I stopped having my salvage therapy. Salvage therapy, we have a volume as well, I ask for family. That's well, our amphotericin, not in volume, and my volume as well, that's well. But sometimes I have to have a therapy. If you go online, maybe amphotericin, but it's a hand of amphotericin, the right. Sometimes we move the glue, I glue, we move the open sinuses. They, in fungus, not to actually invade. It invades the vessels. But for this, the right first, and then start on the fungus. Thank you.